welcome to the 2015 Wilson Buzz. My name is Kaylee.
And I'm Cyan. Scientists announced Thursday the discovery of an almost human. They call it Homo naledi. Homo naledi was found in South Africa. The fossils were 30 meters underground. They have found more than 1,500 fossils since 2013.
Christopher and Cameron are brothers from Georgia accused of trying to kill their parents. They were described by people who knew them as nice kids. They used a pillow and plastic bag to try to kill their mother and stab their father multiple times. The attack came as a surprise to friends, saying the boys came from a loving home. One of the two brothers were planning to kill the parents since he was 11 years old. They said it was for insurance money. Both of the parents survived. And now to your local news.
Hi, my name is Macy.
And my name is Daisy.
And I'm Tatum.
We have breaking news coming at you live. In Kansas City, a mother was charged after kids were found in an underground cave.
A 2- and 6-year-olds were found covered in dirt with no shoes, no toys, no water. All they had were two blankets and a dry cup of ramen noodles.
The two kids have been living in the cave for several days. The 6-year-old claims he should be in first grade but not attending school at all.
On Thursday, the children were taken to Children's Hospital to get some clean clothes and to get cleaned up.
We are all hoping for the best. Thankfully, the children will be okay.
Have a great day, Wilson.
Hi, I'm Ellie.
I'm Caitlin.
And I'm Trisha.
On Monday, September 21st, there is a high of 76 and a low of 48 with scattered thunderstorms.
On Tuesday, September 22nd, there is a high of 76 and a low of 58 with rain.
On Wednesday, September 23rd, there is a high of 75 and a low of 58 with rain in the morning.
On Thursday, September 24th, there is a high of 75 and a low of 54 with rain in the afternoon.
On Friday, September 25th, there is a high of 75 and a low of 56 with a chance of rain in the morning.
And that was this week's weather.
Hi, I'm Clayton.
And I'm Ashton.
And this is Wilson Buzz Sports. Tom Brady has been caught cheating at the AFC Championship game by deflating balls and had to sit out for 4 games this season that has been dropped.
James Jones has left Oakland Raiders and has returned to the Green Bay Packers for a good season this year.
Tom Brady hopes Jazz Trubisky and Jim McNallen returns to work for the Patriots. Aaron Rodgers has told Dan Lee Batard he knows he was not 100% in last year's NFC title game.
Jordy Nelson and A.J. Hawk has left the Green Bay Packers, and nobody knows why.
Eli Manning has been the league's highest paid player. He is going to make $17 million this year.
And that is it for Wilson Buzz Sports.
Hey, I'm Michael.
I'm Peyton.
And I'm Carter.
Wilson's first chance on the field on Monday. Sadly, we lost the football game 35-6 against La Vista. Joe Shute scored the only touchdown for Wilson with a 70-yard touchdown run. Wilson's varsity has a game Thursday.
Also, the girls' volleyball team was excited to get on the court and destroy, but sadly, they lost to Papillion. But they put up a great, awesome fight.
And finally, here's the news about the big rivalry game between TJ and AL. TJ got off to a good start, winning 21-6 at halftime with the lead of quarterback Mitchell Flowers with one rushing touchdown and wide receiver Cameron Baker, who rushed for 2 touchdowns in the first half. At halftime, there was a kicking contest between TJ and AL alumni, and TJ won. Back to the game, AL made a great comeback and stole the lead 33-27. The ball was at the AL 30. TJ was driving the defense blitz and hit quarterback. He threw the ball up to avoid the sack, but it was picked off to win the game, and that's it for the Wilson Sports.
Hi, I'm Rose.
Hi, I'm Kaya.
And this is the school lunch.
On Monday the 21st, we'll be having a barbecue rib on a bun, chicken quesadilla, yogurt with a breadstick, chef salad with a breadstick, corn, carrots and broccoli, juice.
On Tuesday the 22nd, we will be having french fry bar, fresh fruit platter, yogurt with crackers, carrots, broccoli, zucchini, pears, fried and muffin.
On Wednesday the 23rd, we will be having chicken nuggets, pork chop on a bun, yogurt with breadstick, chef salad with breadstick, tossed salad, carrots, celery sticks, applesauce, and fresh fruit.
On Thursday the 24th, we will be having cheeseburger, egg roll, donut, yogurt with a donut, black bean salsa, cucumbers, carrots, juice, and nacho chips.
On Friday the 25th, we will be having a corn dog, chicken fajita, yogurt with a breadstick, chef salad with a breadstick, Mexican rice, tossed salad, veggie relishes, and pineapple.
And that's all for the school lunch.
Hi, I'm Jamie.
And I'm Jenna.
And we are here with the Wilson Food Facts of the Week.
This month is National Potato Month, so we decided to find facts about the most famous things that potatoes make.
Did you know the potato chip was invented in 1835 by George Crumb? George was a chef at the Moon Lake Lodge in Saratoga Spring, New York, U.S. The story behind the potato chip is one day Crumb had a customer who had thought the potato chip, the fries, were too thick, so Crumb made them thinner. But still, the man was not happy. So Crumb made them even thinner, till it was too thin to eat with a fork. Then the potato chip was invented.
Have you ever wondered where the French fry got its name, or even how it was made? French fries are not French. They didn't come from France. French fries actually came from Belgium. That's where they started to fry potatoes. They call it the French fry because the Belgium army was French, and they decided to nickname the fried potatoes French fries. And the name stuck, so that's how the French fries got its French name.
That's it for this week's Fun Food Fact. I'm Jamie.
And I'm Jenna.
We'll see you next time.
Greetings, Wilson. My name is Erin, here with
Alyssa.
And we are here to tell you the school announcements. On September 22nd, there is a Wilson varsity football game at 4 p.m.
Wilson is having a varsity volleyball game on September 24th against Ralston at 4 p.m.
The junior varsity football is having a game against LC on September 24th at 4 p.m.
Have the need to cook? Well, on September 25th, the cooking club is meeting from 3 p.m. to 4:30 p.m.
Junior football is having a game against Kern on September 22nd at 4 p.m.
Need help with your homework? Well, through the 21st to 25th, the homework club is meeting.
The friendship club is meeting 3 p.m. to 4:30 p.m. on September 22nd. And that's all for the school announcements for today. Bye, Wilson.
Hi, I'm Storm.
Hi, I'm Jaden.
This is what's on TV news. On IFC, Insidious will be showing on September 25th, 2:45 p.m. Insidious is about a boy and his family that move into a house with a dark story, and strange stuff happens whenever the boy goes to bed. Strange demons try to take him, so his family have to protect him.
Then at 3:15 p.m., Night at the Museum is on channel BEO on September 25th. It's about a guy who gets a job at a museum, and everything comes to life at the museum, and he has to find a way to keep everything under control.
That's it for TV news.
This is the top 10 movies in the box office. Hotel Transylvania 2 is about a motel of monsters and people stay there and they think it's weird. The Green Inferno is about a group of people in a plane and the plane crashes, and when they wake up, some weird people grab them and tie them up. The Intern is directed by Nancy Myers and is about some old guy and this young lady at a work office.
The Maze Runner Scorched Trials is about this kid named Thomas who goes through the Scorch, and there's a lot of obstacles, but they have to do it because they're fighting the evil organization. Pan is the movie of acting fantasy and is coming out in October 9, 2015. It was directed Joe Wright. The director is Joe Wright and written by Jason Futches. It stars Hugh Jackman. The Martin is about a guy who is trapped on Mars and he had to survive and grow crops, but Mars is also known as a planet of non-growing. The movie is coming out on October 2nd, 2015.
And that is all for the top 10 movies in the box office.
Hi, my name is Tom.
And my name is Bryce.
And this is what's hot on Netflix. Big Daddy is an old comedy and it's funny, and it is about a guy that is not a father, and he adopts a kid, and then the real dad takes him back, and now to my associate.
Earth's Echo is about a movie about a small alien crash landed into the middle of nowhere, and kids help him try to get back home.
That's it for what's hot on Netflix. See you later, Wilson.
Hi, I'm Tony.
I'm Julio.
And I'm Victor.
And this is going to be Actor of the Week, and it is
Adam Sandler.
The sequel to the hit Adam Sandler movie with your favorite monsters, Hotel Transylvania 2, is coming out September 25th, 2015, featuring Selena Gomez and Kevin James.
Dracula opened his hotel to humans. Things are going to become better, but he is worried about his half-vampire grandson, so he pulls him to monster training to try to get him to a vampire side of him.
Adam Sandler, the famous actor that plays an important role as the character Dracula, and Selena Gomez, which plays the character Mavis, which is Dracula's daughter. Also Kevin James as Frankenstein, Dracula's friend.
Adam Sandler is a very successful actor, but is very split with the community. His movies are very successful. Adam Sandler is getting paid $80 million for his next four movies that are being streamed on Netflix and not in theater.
And that's all for the Actor of the Week.
Hi, I'm Haley.
Hi, I'm Paxton.
Hi, I'm Alexis.
And this is the Actor of the Week.
Duff Cameron is an American actress. Her birthday is January 15, 1996. Duff was born in Seattle. She was the big star of The Family Liv and Maddie. Lastly, how did Duff become famous? She played in the movie Descendants in which she was Mal, the daughter of Maleficent. She also got famous and she acted in a show with Emma. She played two episodes. She started acting when she was at local community center, and that's when she became famous. Here's Paxton with her Actor of the Week.
Today I'm going to be talking to you about Zac Efron. When Zac was a seven-year-old, his father, David Efron, said that someday he would make an amazing actor. Later in high school, Zac appeared in a school play, The Boy Who Wouldn't Grow Up. He was really interested, so he decided to be in more plays. That led him to fame. His very first movie was High School Musical, and that got him on backpacks and t-shirts. Today, he has been acting in many movies, such as The Lucky One, all three High School Musicals, and a lot more. His newest movie is We Are Friends, and right now, his biggest movie is Neighbors with Seth Rogen. That's all I have for now. Now, here is Alexis with her Actor of the Week.
Today I'm going to talk about Jamie Campbell Bower. He was born on November 22, 1988. He's an English actor, singer, and model. He is best known for his roles Anthony Pope in Sweeney Todd, the Demon Harbor of Fleet Sheet, King Arthur in the series Camelot, Gilbert Grindelwald in Harry Potter and the Deathly Hallows Part 1, and lastly, Jace Wallen in the Mortal Instruments City of Bones.
And there are your Actors of the Week. Bye, Wilson.
Hi, I'm Jace.
And I'm Brandy.
This is the Wilson Buzz
Top 10 Billboard. Spot number 10, Where Are You Now? Skrillex and Diplo featuring Justin Bieber. Last week, it was
9, Lock Away, Our City featuring Adam Levine.
Spot 8, 679 Fitty Wap featuring Remy Boyce.
7, Good For You, Selena Gomez.
Spot number 6, Lean On, Major Lazer, featuring DJ Snake.
Cheerleader by Omi. Watch Me by Silento.
Spot number 3, The Hills by The Weeknd. Last week it was spot number 4.
Number 2, I Can't Feel My Face by The Weeknd. Last week it was spot number 1.
And spot number 1, What Do You Mean by Justin Bieber. This was the top 10 Billboard for this week. Goodbye, Wilson.
Hi, I'm Mackenzie.
I'm Jeanette.
And I'm Natalie.
Today we are going to be talking about the featured artists of the week. This week is 5 Seconds of Summer. The band consists of Luke Hemmings, the lead singer, Michael Clifford, the lead guitarist, Callum Hood, the bass guitarist, and Ashton Allen, the drummer.
They are an Australian pop punk band. They first started as just Luke, Callum, and Michael.
When they got the first gig, they needed a drummer and found Ashton.
They began an official band on December 3rd, 2011.
Later that year, One Direction discovered them doing a cover of Teenage Dirtbag. They have two albums released with another one on the way.
Some of their newest songs are She's Kinda Hot and Fly Away, and many more on the new album. The album is called Sounds Good, Feels Good. And that's all for this week. Thanks for watching.
Hi, I'm Jordan.
I'm CJ.
And I'm Ryan. And this is the Wilson Book Review.
The Diary of a Wimpy Kid is a funny book. This is great for you if you like comedy.
The author, Jeff Kenney, is amazing and writes funny books that you will love.
The Diary of a Wimpy Kid series is funny in every sentence. Always get a kick out of it every time I read it. I think you will like it too. The book Lockdown, Escape from Furnace is a thrill that has lots of action and crazy parts. There's four books.
It's a very funny book to start with, but gets lost every book with the monster that you learn about the other monsters. And this is
the Wilson Book Review.
This is Serenity
and Rosa.
With the history of characters,
Mickey Mouse is a funny animal cartoon character and the official mascot of Walt Disney Company. He was created by Walt Disney at Walt Disney Studios in 1928. Walt Disney was his voiced first, then he died. Brent Lewis is the voice of him now. 1928, Steamboat Willie featuring Mickey Mouse was released on November 18th, 1928. It was the first Mickey Mouse cartoon.
Donald Duck is a cartoon character created in 1934 at Walt Disney Productions. Clarence Nash was the first person to voice Donald Duck. His first appearance, The Wise Little Hen, Donald Duck first appeared in Silly Symone's cartoon characters, The Wise Little Hen, June 9th. Goofy performed in an animated cartoon started in 1932 with Mickey Review. This is Serenity
and Rosa
with the character history.
It's Tyler Carver
and Damon Britton
with the Sports Figure of the Week. J.J. Watt is our Sports Figure of the Week.
Justin James, or known as J.J. Watt, he was born on March 22nd, 1989. He was born in Waukesha, Wisconsin. He is an American football defense end for the Houston, Texas of the National Football League, NFL.
He was drafted by the Texans in the first round in the 2011 NFL Draft. He played college for the Wisconsin Badgers.
His first job was delivering pizzas for Pizza Hut. Now he's making $100 million for another 6 years.
During recruiting, he was the seventh best prospect in Wisconsin and got picked up by Central Michigan, but didn't do that good, so he got transferred to the Badgers and got Defensive Player of the Year award. And that's all for the Sports Figure of the Week.
Hello and welcome to Video Game News. I'm Alex.
And I'm Cole. Let's talk about YouTube launching YouTube Gaming, their own version of the popular live streaming app Twitch.
Yeah, YouTube and Twitch are going head-to-head. But anyways, let's talk about the app. It's available on iOS and Android for free.
Yeah, it's pretty cool. You can stream on it and just post videos.
In other news, here's Cole's top five games of the month.
The top five games of the month are number one, Batman Arkham Knight for the PlayStation 4, number two, Splatoon for the Wii U, number three, Batman Arkham Knight for the Xbox One, number four, Lost Dimension for the PlayStation Vita, and number five, Grand Theft Auto V for the PlayStation 4.
The popular game, Plague Inc., will be available on Xbox One on September 18th.
Which also has new features like DLC and also 9 new diseases and 20 unique scenarios.
Also, WWE 2K16 has revealed 12 legends on their roster.
2K16 has an exciting roster with 12 legends including Bret Hart, Billy Gunn, Jim Neidhart, and Shawn Michaels, and new superstars will also be added to the game.
In other news, Minecraft is releasing Minecraft Story on PS4, PS3, Xbox One, Xbox 360, and and PC.
And lastly, celebrating Mario's 30th anniversary.
Happy birthday, Mario. I'm Alex.
And I'm Cole.
And this was Video Game News.
This is Game Reviews. Hi, my name is Zach Madsen. Elder Scrolls is most played on PS4, Xbox One, and PC. Elder Scrolls has strong combat system, most rewarding and highly complicated game. Elder Scrolls has great quest lines and greatly customized combat. Elder Scrolls is a game that you have to be smart about your attack skills. For example, observe how your enemies fight and attacks they use. Elder Scrolls Online is a game that is impacted on the player level in weapons and use. The XP is impact on how much damage and how much you aggro.
Hello, my name is Max Schuster. Destiny is a great game. It has great AI for fighting against. Also, some awards you can get are handy for Crucible, where you fight against other people, or against the Darkness, all the enemies of the game that you can find while exploring. One of the best weapons in the game that's good for Crucible is known as the Last Word. It's an exotic weapon, which is one of the rarest kinds of weapons to get in the game. There may be a few glitches here and there, but they give you a good laugh.
In The Taken King, the hunter has a bow and arrow, and the warlock has a better magic. The titan has a hammer. I like that the weapons you start with are better than what you start with in the first Destiny, and there are now exotic cloaks. And that's all for the game reviews of the week.
Hi, I'm Andrew.
And I am Nolan.
We are here with apps of the week. There's a new game for Android called Z-War. It has 5,000 downloads and 3,362 people play it. What you do is go through town shooting zombies and saving the innocent people. At the end of the game, you fight the boss zombie with a chainsaw.
There is a game called Fruit Ninja, and Fruit Ninja has been downloaded by more than 1 billion people play it. And what you do is cut the fruit and earn points. Upgrade at the end, there is a big fruit you hit until it blows up.
Hi, this is Jamin.
This is Doug.
And this is Technology of the Week. Apple has announced iPhone 6 and iPhone 6 Plus, adding a powerful new dimension to iPhone's revolutionary multi-touch screen.
The new iPhone introduced 3D Touch, which enables new ways to access features and interact with content.
iPhone 6 and iPhone 6 Plus feature HD displays made from the strongest glass of any smartphone in 7000 series, aluminum finishes that now include rose gold.
The new iPhone also introduces a new approach to photography called Blurred Photos, bringing still images to life by capturing a moment in motion using a highly advanced fingerprint sensor that's now faster and better than ever. Touch ID makes unlocking your phone easy and secure.
The iPad Pro has the most advanced display screens ever made. The 12.9-inch screen offers 70% more display area than that of the iPad Air 2.
Under the glass lies a multi-touch subsystem and 5.6 million brilliant pixels, making it the highest resolution display of any iOS device.
That extreme resolution, along with remarkably lifelike colors and deeper blacks, makes everything from photo editing to intense 3D games more vivid and deeply engaging.
Thank you for watching,
and this is the Technology of the Week.
Hey Wilson, this is Zach with the History of the Week. This week I will be telling you the history of Will Smith, September 25th, 1968, an American actor who played in Men in Black series and The Fresh Prince of Bel-Air, and is a rapper named DJ Jazzy Jeff. The International Day of Peace, sometimes unofficially known as World Peace Day, is observed annually on the 21st September. It is dedicated to world peace and especially to advance the war and violence. United Kingdom, 1937. Great Britain, The Hobbit, published 21st September 1937. J.R.R. Tolkien's The Hobbit was published. That's for the facts of the week. Bye, Wilson.
Hi, my name is Ruth.
I'm Anna.
I'm Stephanie.
And these are the holidays of the week.
International Day of Peace is on September 21st. This day is mostly about ideals of peace, having peace on one, at least one day of the year, also on a holiday. In some parts of the country, the community comes together for peace. They do some really fun activities, not all of us do.
International Ice Cream Cone Day, held on 22nd of September. How to celebrate it? Well, you just grab your cone, fill it with ice cream, and enjoy. You are celebrating National Ice Cream Cone.
Nickelodeon Worldwide Day of Play is a day where Nickelodeon tries to convince kids and parents to turn off the TV and go outside and do something active. The first event was on October 25th, 2004. It's also related to Let's Just Go Play Healthy. Nick has many of their stars going around the country to go get kids moving and do something active outside.
On September 22nd, it's the day of National White Chocolate Day. White chocolate doesn't really count as an actual chocolate because it doesn't have cocoa solids in it, because the cocoa beans are counted as fatty content, and the white chocolate doesn't contain much caffeine in it.
Graphic Novel Day, celebrate on the 25th of September. Where anybody who loves graphic novels, well, this is your day. Also called a comic magazine, comics actually existed in America since the printing of the Adventures of Obadiah Old Book in 1842 in hardcover, making it the first known American prototype comic book.
National Great American Pot Pie Day is where 23 million people celebrate this with pies filled with beef, chicken, or turkey, gravy, mixed vegetables like potatoes, carrots, green beans, and peas. It can be bought or homemade. That's all.
Hola, mi nombre es Luis, y hoy les voy a contar sobre la tradición mexicana del Día de Muertos. La celebración del Día de Muertos es el 2 de noviembre. Ese día las señoras se levantan temprano para ir a comprar flores. Luego van a la cocina a preparar diferentes platillos, como tacos, enchiladas, tamales y pozole, que llevan a la tumba de familiares y amigos. Ese día el cementerio es muy alegre. Afuera del cementerio también hay ventas de comidas mexicanas. Eso es todo por hoy. Gracias.
Hi Wilson, I'm Leah.
I'm Vanna.
And this is Facts of the Week.
Did you know the safest color is white?
Did you know that if you combined all the ants in the world, they weigh as much as the humans in the world?
Did you know that your foot has 26 bones in it?
Did you know a snail can sleep for 3 years at a time?
Did you know a cat has 32 muscles in each ear?
Get this, since it's football season, did you know 78% of NFL players are bankrupt after 2 years of finishing the careers, and 60% of NBA players are bankrupt within 5 years of leaving the league?
Did you know bears have 42 teeth?
Did you know that lightning strikes the earth 6,000 times every minute?
Do you know reindeer like bananas?
Did you know that nachos were invented by a guy named Nacho? And that's all for Facts of the Week.
Hi.
Hi, I'm Mary.
Hi, I'm Savannah. This is On the Right.
And On the Wrong.
Stop running. Stop running, please.
And now to Officer Height with the safety tip of the week.
Good morning, Wilson students, and this is Officer Height with this week's safety tip. In light of last week's incident on 21st and G, where one of our students unfortunately was hit by a vehicle, students doing fine, by the way, Officer Height wants to talk to you about safety rules when you're coming to school or walking home from school, and then a little bit of an announcement as well. Remember, when you're walking to and from school, use the crosswalks. Don't cross in the middle of the street. Make sure that you cross at the crosswalks where people are expecting you to cross. That also goes for people riding bicycles. Make sure to look both ways before you cross, and just don't assume that a vehicle is going to stop and wait for you. Sometimes they may not see you, so don't just assume a car is going to stop if you walk out into the street, because they may not. As far as the news goes, we're actually going to have a crossing guard at the area of 21st and G now. Within the next few days, he'll start work there. So please utilize the crossing guard. He's going to be there for your safety. Kind of collect near him, and then he'll walk everybody across the street or make sure that Avenue G, the traffic on Avenue G, is stopped before you cross the street. So utilize the crossing guard every morning and every day after school, and he'll help you stay safe. So remember, when you're coming to and from school, do what's right. Make sure you look both ways and be alert what's going on around you. That's this week's safety tip. Have a good week. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Mariella.
And I'm Abby.
And we're here with the quotes of the week.
I heard a voice that told me I was essential, how all my fears are limiting my potential. Said, it's time to step into the light and use every bit of power I have inside. I like this quote because I feel like it had a very powerful message, starting with, I heard a voice that told me I was essential, which means absolutely necessary, extremely important. And then going on to say, your fears are limiting your potential, which means forget your fears and go for what you were after. Then it says, it's time to step into the light and use every bit of power you have inside, which means it's time to step up and make your point because you're a very powerful person.
Everyone has a bad day, and sometimes an inspirational quote can pick you right back up. This is why I picked this one, because it's saying you don't always need a plan, letting you know it's okay to go off the chart. Do something big. Also, it says sometimes you need to breathe, so going off the chart, it's good. Doing something you wouldn't do every day. The last part, trust, let go, and see what happens. What it means, just what it says. Let go. Don't always try to stop things that are unusual. It might take you somewhere you have never been, and you could like it.
That's all for quotes of the week.
Hi, Wilson. Welcome to Funny Jokes of the Week.
Hi, I'm Cheyenne Carey.
Hello, I'm Savannah McAllister. Why are you late?
Because of the sign.
What sign?
The one that says school ahead, go slow. Why did the boy put candy under his pillow?
Because he wanted sweet dreams. Knock, knock.
Who's there?
I love.
I love who?
I don't know, you tell me.
Knock, knock.
Who's there?
A little girl.
A little girl who?
A little girl that can't reach the doorbell. What did the English book say to the math book?
You've got way too many problems. And that's it for the jokes of the week.
Hi, I'm Wyatt. And I'm Mason.
And this is Jokes of the Week.
What is a knight's favorite fish?
I don't know. What?
A swordfish.
What's a robot's favorite snack?
What is it?
Computer chips.
Why did the turkey cross the road?
I don't know.
To prove it wasn't chicken.
You want to hear a dirty joke?
Sure.
A boy fell in a mud puddle.
Do you want to hear a clean joke?
Sure.
He took a bath.
What's the difference between a teacher and a train?
What?
A teacher says spit out the gum, and a train says choo choo.
What is the king of all school supplies?
I don't know. What?
The ruler.
And that's it for jokes of the week.
And that's it for the Wilson Buzz. Have a good day, Wilson.